A Mitchell County man is arrested after deputies find out he's making moonshine at his house.
Ed Silver is charged with misdemeanor possession and sale of non-tax alcohol and making liquor without a permit. News 13 Cheryl Barber talked with deputies about this raid.
Now, Cheryl, this all went down very easy for the officers.
They say Ed Silver cooperated with them fully after they got a tip he was making and selling unbonded spirits.
The sheriff received some complaints.
Complaints that a farmer on Highway 80
just confronted him and asked him, and he was very upfront.
Upfront about an operation downstairs.
He told us he had it and said it's in the basement and took us right in the basement where it was at.
And this is what they found. Stacks of quart jars, mostly filled with high-quality corn liquor. Close to 150 gallons of untaxed home brew.
It was sort of a small operation, really. It looks big with the amount of stuff we seized, but he only had about 500 gallons of mash, 25-gallon cooker, had a stainless steel cooker, copper connections, no way of getting lead in it. Very clean.
Captain Rick Wiseman knows a good still when he sees one because he spent 22 years tracking down moonshiners and busting up stills in North Carolina. He says Ed Silver was selling the hooch for about $20 a quart. He says his customers don't have to worry about lead poisoning, but he says the mountains still have those willing to take the risk of getting caught.
In the area we live in, you still have some old timers. This is heritage to them.
That's kind of surprising. I thought that was a thing of the past.
Heritage or enterprise, people we talked with were surprised a man they know would allegedly build a still.
I suspect Ed was probably just making that for himself and his neighbors, but he's a fine fella and he's not a criminal.
Hard times out now. I guess people's just trying to make money.
People's just trying to make money too. There's no jobs, no factories left here, and they gotta do what they can to make money.
Silver is free on $2,000 bond. His next court appearance is scheduled for June 6th.